President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. leads the lighting of the iconic San Juanico Bridge. The more than 2-kilometer bridge that spans across the provinces of Samar and Leyte is now illuminated with lights and a laser show called The Spark. The 80 million peso project, which began in 2015, is seen to boost tourism in the area. At the ceremony, President Marcos recalled fond memories about the San Juanico Bridge, which was completed during his father's presidency in the early 70s.
It was my father who spearheaded the inauguration of the bridge. So you can all imagine how genuinely delighted I am to be present to witness the lighting as your president. I look forward to the economic opportunities that will be stimulated by this as well as other Spark Summer initiatives in the near future.
A Philippine school module draws concern over its attempt to revise the country's martial law period. The discovery of the learning material came amid the Education Department's denial of a rebranding of martial law lessons in its basic curriculum. Joyce Balancho reports.
School student from Marinduque State College Integrated High School reveals on social media they are being taught to refer to the martial law era as Bagong Lipunan or the period of new society in their literature class. In her Twitter post, Maria Elena Malvar said the period supposedly covers the years 1972 to 1980. Malvar made the post in reaction to a news article on the denial of the Department of Education that the martial law period is being rebranded.
Nakalewa kasi doon 1972 and then 1982, 1980. Sabi ko, diba yun yung martial law? And naalala ko bigla yung post na iyon. Yung post about dun sa historical revisionism na iyon. And sabi ko, hala, nangyari na pala. Akala ko nung una rumors or hakahaka pa lang.
In the said module, the period started on September 21, 1972, or the date when former President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. declared martial law in the country. The module also indicated newspapers then focused on economic progress, discipline, culture, tourism among others, and were more favored over sensationalized reporting of crimes like killings and robberies. Malvar sees this as an attempt to distort history.
Parang nagiging tool ito para sa regime, para makalimutan yung atrocities of the past, and para in-enable yung mga katiwalian sa ating gobyerno as of now sa paggawa ng mga pagbigay ng mga maling impormasyon sa mga kabataan. Parang ini-indoctrinate po kasi nila yung mga kabataan.
Malvar isn't alone. A senior high school teacher from Manila revealed that many facts were censored when they were asked to revise the curriculum for the humanities and social sciences.
We had this one day of, given this one day of revision, parang ginawa niyan, ang tawag nga namin ng mga writers doon ay cleansing and censorship. Kasi tinignan yung bawat module, bawat chapter, kung if there is a mention with martial law, the Marcos era of administration, not just the part of martial law, but the entire era of former President Marcos Sr. No, at pati EDSA People Power.
Lakian added they were also asked to revise some activities or articles that could have been used as references.
Sa EDSA People Power, na activity, ito ay patungkol sa topic na freedom. At tinanggal din nila yun. Kasi ang topic namin dun is freedom of speech, expression, and how humans should express their feelings as well as their beliefs. So tinanggal yun yung activity na yun.
For the Alliance of Concerned Teachers, these reports are alarming, noting that the administration could be starting historical revisionism in schools. ACT Partilis Congresswoman Franz Castro said teachers have an important role in making sure that students are taught historical facts. The Department of Education confirmed that the module that used the term period of the new society was crafted during the Duterte administration by one of their regional offices. The agency says it is still gathering information on the matter. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.